You will not believe what I'm going to show you now. Well, not me, Bryan. And he's killed a female nyala, just sitting in the tree there. Well, not sitting, more kind of draped. Doesn't have too much of a choice about it. And then there's also a hyena lurking about here in the... Well, everything's shaded at the moment. A thick blanket of cloud is hanging over us. And that's the most patient animal out here. The hyena's waiting for bits and pieces of this hapless nyala cow to drop to the floor so that he can eat them. This is a three-year-old. He's in his father's territory. And we haven't seen him for some time. In fact, Bryan, I think you and I were the last to see him with a kudu kill that we had pilfered from him by hyenas. Brent then did see him on foot, but couldn't get a vehicle in to see him. And he is, in fact, Brent's favorite leopard. Pretty correct. This is Kunyuma. Just about approaching his third birthday. Magnificent male leopard. Son of Karula, an 11-year-old female, pushing 12. She was born, if I'm not mistaken, in 2004. And her consort, Mvula. And that's whose territory Kunyuma is living in at the moment. I know quarantine is on Nkoro, which is not too far from here, to the southeast. So he's still around, also in his dad's territory. Now he's looking at us. He's looking around. I don't know what's disturbed him. I don't think he's going to leave here for very long. Leopards are very graceful going up the trees. They're not often that graceful coming down. You can feel the wind blowing. It's quite chilly out here. Probably only about 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Gormless creature that this one is, it has not noticed at all. He's very full, and sitting in the tree has become very uncomfortable for him, and that's why he's got out of the tree and lain down on the ground. What a privilege this has been.